put your hands, and now my hands are freezing. Okay. And almost dig that hand in. Yeah. See the difference there? That's what we want. Okay. But we don't want to be leaning back here. Okay. So the trick to making your waist look small, especially just looking at, obviously, from you on stairs last week, lean a little bit into it forward. Say your hips are almost back a little bit and you're turning. Yes. You see the difference there in here? They need to see that gap. Yeah? Yes, it's way better. Get the hip in more. Yeah. There you go. Bring the hand position up a little bit more. There you go. Better, much better. Feel that, okay? This is how that has to feel, yeah? Quarter turn. Quarter turn. Yes, very good. That's your best shot. Squeeze. Quarter turn. What has happened, guys? So this is the first video for my YouTube channel. So today's video is going to be a day in the life of me as a prep coach, as some of you will know, most of you won't, obviously, who are new to the channel. But it's just going to be all about giving you guys an insight as to what I do on a day-to-day basis. Obviously, the intricacies around coaching, going to shows, in the gym, in the facility here, and just again, giving you that insight as to what my life entails. Just bring the hip a little bit more to here, and then bring the elbow back more. Yeah, and just pop the elbow back more. Yes. Yeah. You see for that back, go again, just roll really hard for me back. So when we're rolling, don't just worry about pulling hair back. Squeeze everything back and down for me, okay? Like you're actually doing a seated row and pulling the hair. Yeah, and pull down. There you go. Yes. Just hit that again. So really exaggerate, squeeze them back. Good. Much better. And lean back. Now quarter turn and show the tricep. And tricep, there you go. Really good. Abs tight, control that. Quarter turn. And abs tight. Good, when we go downstairs, yeah? We're gonna go front as you're doing it, quarter turn as you're doing it, back as you're doing it, hold the tricep for a split second, into the side pose, then go into just to show that side with the arms down, arms on the hip, hands open for this federation, shoulders, elbows pushed forward, only for a second or two, and then back into our front pose. Yeah. 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 Pop. Yeah. Beautiful. Squeeze. Yeah. Now just here, hold both hands on the hip. Pop the elbows forward. Yes, now to the front pose. But when we get to that front pose, yes, it's such a good pose for you. That transition ties everything together for you. So you're here. Yeah, squeeze and lean. Get the hips back when you hit that, yeah? So arse back to the curtains, yeah? Squeeze. And it's only for a second, and then it's actually into our front pose. For a turn. Yes. Pop, get out of it, yeah? Beautiful. You feel that flow? The flow is better, doesn't it? And not everybody has that pose in their arsenal. So it just adds to it. Because you're hitting it, also obviously illustrating where you're strong, but also, you know, it's showing that level of confidence as well. That's really important. It's eye-catching, you know. The way, obviously, men's physique was years ago with, like, hand movements and all this silly stuff. You know, you want to be catching the judge's eye with your transitions, with how you hit them poses. And remembering that the transitions can be poses in themselves because the judges are looking at you, you know. So every transition should illustrate a strong point. One more time. Quarter turn. Quarter turn. Quarter turn. Abs, yeah. Quarter turn. The split second here. Yeah. Pop to the front pose. Yes. What I don't want you to do is like hold that pose as if it's a pose. It's literally just transitioning back into our pose. So yeah, they are poses, but we're hitting them like 2 seconds, 2 seconds, kaboom. It's just using the opportunity to show more. Yeah? I just want to get pictures of that. Gee, the emphasis for PCI and the emphasis for muscle contest in Alicante is make sure that, you know, we are not seeking fat loss within peak week. We're only mitigating fatigue and we're looking to go as full, as dry as possible. But, you know, we don't want to, you know, do anything through this peak week that's going to hold us or stall us then within that trajectory of going to the next shows. Yeah, obviously the next shows, so the caliber gets higher and higher and higher. I'm peaking at Alicante. Yeah, super. All right, my man. So we are gonna go through my chest and back session now. Obviously today being Monday, this is a session one of the week. Again, this is, as I've said at the start, you know, it's all about my life as a prep coach as well as my own road back into bodybuilding. Something I've been very open with was the importance of fertility, obviously with myself and Eva, who'll be on this channel. We have plans, hopefully after she secures her pro card, of having a kid. So long story short, she's given me a year window. So within that now, this is obviously episode one. The goal is to get myself back in the conversation to be able to compete again. For my structure, I know that I need to be pushing my body weight, you know, to excess 120 kilograms for me to be back in that conversation. So I'm going to show you as well just an insight into the intricacies of what way I'm going to go about that. I coach myself. So yeah, we'll be going down everything from, you know, supplementation routes to mesocycles, nutrition protocols, where I'm at now. I'm actually just waiting on my blood test results. Something that I preach to all my clients would be, you know, if when they're on cycle, etc., every 8 to 12 weeks is when we're sort of looking at getting bloods taken. So to start again, we're looking at that approach of test, don't guess. So I'm just waiting on the results now, my blood test and supplementation stack design we built from that, with the goal, as I said, as to get as much tissue on my frame as possible before I nail down some show dates and have one last dance. I think that would actually be the name of the series, should be one last dance. Fuck Michael Jordan. So today we are starting off with cable flies, just to get some blood into the pec. We're gonna go upstairs then, no sorry, we're gonna go onto the Smith machine, we're going into our incline, Smith machine press, no bands. Then we're upstairs onto a sternal chest press. They're gonna be our two chest exercises, obviously our priming movement here. Then we're going onto a pronated grip T-bar row, and then we're going onto a single arm grip row, finishing with two triceps, two biceps. So it's a nice balanced session, something that my physique needs. As I said, this is all about bringing you guys down sort of outside of, you know, what my clients' needs are and more individual to me, and what I need to be able to, as I said, sort of determine it as getting back into the conversation again. So, yeah, you'll see how the session goes. Jack just asked me a really good question there, and that is, obviously with the shows this weekend, and we're sort of amidst now the show season, does my schedule change much on peak week when I've athletes competing that week? The answer is yeah, due to the fact that obviously peak week is very individualized to that said client. But when we're looking at, you know, obviously I've multiple clients that aren't at peak week, so there's still 8, 9, 10 hours of work to be done with my actual clientele, plus, you know, the clients then that are competing on the weekend, they're now on daily check-ins. So every day, you know, it's added workload. And then check-ins, to be quite frank, are 3-4 times a day. So, you know, I have clients that will send me their FASA pictures in the morning that obviously are on peak week or competing on a Sunday. They'll then, if they're gonna be on stage at say 2-3 o'clock, they'll train at 2-3 o'clock. They'll send me their post-workout pictures with a pump. And then again, they'll send me pictures then pre-bed. And again, it's just based on the information then is relayed back to me, and it's all about how they're responding day to day, and obviously then with the next days and what is planned within that peak week for them as to what way their physique reacts. And then with the whole premise behind peak week being, you know, mitigate fatigue, and then bring that said client, male or female, in as dry and as full as possible, the different stages throughout the week as sort of projecting that look that we want. So yeah, it is. Long story short, it is a lot more hectic. So my days where they could go from, you know, 13, 14 hour work days go from, you know, 14 to 18 hour work days. And it's just, you know, giving the clientele, you know, your time and the effort that they deserve. Because at the end of the day, how they project themselves then on the Sunday, on the Saturday, whatever day the show is a direct reflection on as to what I've done with them. So, yeah, that's what I say. That's why it is.
Especially when you have clients doing multiple shows, you're obviously collecting data. You're collecting information for
good question. So because, as I said at the start of that there, it's, you know, there's an array of shows. So let's say Kevin or Mikey, who you would have seen today, you know, they're going to be competing in all in 3, 4, 5 shows. So Kevin, for example, is doing this weekend. Then he's up in Derry at PCA, and then he's going to Limerick for the muscle contest, and then he's out to Alicante then for the Amateur Olympia. So, you know, it's okay, well, his first time competing is now. So when we're looking at, yeah, it's a peak week, but there's not, you know, peak week can be a term that's very miscommunicated, misled, or just wrongly termed, that there's magic potions and pills to take throughout this week. And it's not, as I said, it's mitigating fatigue, getting that client as full and as dry as possible, but not sabotaging later shows. So Kevin, for example, you know, we're still seeking some fat loss through this peak week. So for us, nothing that we're doing this week is to sabotage when we actually want to be at our best, which is PCA Muscle Contest Alicante. So for this week, for Kevin, it's just sort of cruising this week. Cruising through this week is business as usual. Again, giving me as much data 3-4 times a day as possible. And then when we get to PCA, well, then that's when, you know, fat loss is gone. It is all just be fatigue free, full, dry, and then make sure then that we can relay that back in. And but again, you know, it's being able to create a predictable look based on replicable data. So that data that I collect, you know, from refeeds, from mini cuts, from, you know, tolerances or intolerances as that individual has spoken up, all pays dividends throughout this week. And that's when the client needs you most to be able to produce that look for them. Let's go, come up. 5, and again. Let's go, come on. Push. All the way. One more in the tank, let's go. One more. Let's go, come on. Fight it. Come on, all you, lock it. Yes, drop. So I'm going 2 working sets here on incline Smith press. And we're going to go 1 working set upstairs on sternal pec. Then we're going on to 2 working sets down on T-bar. And then on to a single working set then on single arm NutriGrip rows. Hey! Let's go. Take the last two. Let's go, Jack. Let's go. Yes. One. Let's go. Come on. Control every inch. Let's work. Push. Push. Yes. Come on. Good set. As you've seen now, that's two sets on incline Smith. Now one set, doing everything you have, emptying the tank on sternal focus chest press, so sternal emphasis chest press, so sternal pec being essentially mid pec, clavicular, being worked on the incline, costal, anything from coming down here. What we're moving on to now is T-bar row, focusing on pronated grip, because again, for my own physique, that top line, both from the anterior and posterior, it's lacking. So again, it's clawing back to where I was, and these are really going to be staple movements now throughout this journey again. Go, come on. All you, let's go, come on. Chest down, come on. Let's go. Let's go, up, up, up. What's that? Okay.
Drive, come on. Come on. Five, yes. Seven, yes. Come on. Eight, yep. Nine, come on. Ten, yes. Come on. Six, two, come on. Let's go. Good. 12, match it, yeah, 13. Match it, come on, let's go. Yes.
Good. One more, let's go. Come on. Yes, hold on. Now we work. Come on. Now we push. These are the reps, Jack. Yes, yes. These are the reps. Come on. Let's go. Make it. Make it. Make it. Yes. Hold on. So I know this video started as, you know, an introduction for me on YouTube to bring you guys through and sort of in that journey with me as a coach. But a question that I've been asked from those closest to me, and something that I briefly touched on, was why am I giving bodybuilding for myself one last go? Why am I getting back up on stage one last time when I have established myself as one of the leading prep coaches in the country? And the reason is simple, you know. For me now, it's personal. So I'm not doing it for anybody else. Back when I was in my early 20s, when I competed, you know, I was competing, but the only thing that's important to me, and that hasn't really changed, is coaching. But back then, you know, looking back, I was possibly competing just for that, to further my coaching business within the competitive realm. And, you know, that is important when you're looking at having empathy for clients and being in the trenches and knowing what they're going through at different times, etc. So it is a vital component, but that was my main driver then. Now I'm thankfully in the position where I have a full roster of athletes and you know, my passion is and always will be only around coaching, but I've still got one itch left, you know, that I just need to scratch, and that is around bodybuilding. And again, when I competed for the last time was 2015, 2016. It was at a time where I was just writing my thesis, that was coming to the ultimatum at the same time as prep. I had some life situations I was going through, and you know, it just didn't turn out, that prep didn't turn out as I wanted, and that for me was supposed to be the last time. But now I find myself in a position where I've been vocal on my Instagram that myself and Eva, you know, we are going to be looking to have kids soon, soon being a year's time. Eva is on her own path now, and the goal for her now is to get that pro card. So ideally for us, I have that window now of opportunity where it's now or never for me to scratch that itch again. So it's a case here that although you're going to get a big insight as to my life as a coach, I want to really bring everybody along for the ride as to, you know, getting myself back in the position where I am in conversation again to compete again. And obviously with me coaching myself, You know, I treat myself as I treat a client. Everything is strategic. Everything is phased out. You know, I'm awaiting bloods now where we'll be looking at certain markers. Again, I'll be very open about this. And then the stack design will be built off that, where it is simply just to escalate outside physiological ranges, see the response, titrate up from there. But I'm under no, you know, illusions here how much of a hill I have to climb with the amount of time I have. But I'm confident I'll do it because of the fact that, you know, I'm all in here the same way as I am with coaching. This next 12 months, I'm all in with getting myself back to where I was, and further to get myself back up on stage and competitive again for one last time. I just want to again overemphasize that this is one last dance for me. It's not a case that I have aspirations to go, you know, be a pro, etc. For me, the only thing that is, you know, hugely important is that I continuously improve my coaching service. For this, for me, is, as I said, it's personal. So again, I will break down the intricacies around my own journey, coaching myself to where I want to be, as well as obviously always giving you guys an insight as to my life as a coach and the day-to-day process of what I go through, from getting up at 4 a.m., doing my mandatory research, replying to check-ins, coming in here, bringing you guys through my session, through my meals, through, you know, any modulations that I make, back to check-ins, 400 cans of Mule Monster, and repeat until the inevitable is and I'm back up on stage. So that's it, guys. So I hope you enjoyed the video today, and thank you for subscribing.